Each year, as winter loosens its hold on tracks across the nation, there is a taste of anticipation as a new season arrives. A season of hope. A season of trials. Of tribulations. A new season of racing. On the eastern edge of Kansas City, Missouri, lies the town of Green Valley. Here, we find Valley Speedway, one of many small dirt tracks dotted around the Midwest. It is playing host to the first race of the 2017 season on a cool Saturday night in April. As fans begin to fill the grandstands, you feel the excitement build. Race teams have had all off-season to prepare, and now it's finally time to put that hard work to the test. Back in the pit area, crews are already working on final preparations for tonight's race. Every nut and bolt is checked, and fine-tuning adjustments are performed. Multiple classes are running tonight, E and B modifieds, non-wing sprint cars, Power Eye Outlaw Midgets, Outlaw Street Stocks, and the four-cylinder Dirt Demon class. The nightly rituals begin as the cars are required to go through the Room of Doom, tech inspection, where the cars either pass their test or go back for more work. Next is the driver's meeting. All drivers must attend to go over rules, regulations, and track information.
First thing, try the new battery. Try to drive the new battery. Hopefully your earbuds, please.
After the meeting, cars make their way toward the arena and begin to form up into groups. The arena, in this instance, is carved from the earth itself. A racetrack measuring 3/8 of a mile long, made from a mixture of clay and soil to provide a racing surface that is able to withstand the pounding of the thousands of horsepower it will see tonight. The track is rough, narrow, and hard to tame, and that's just why these drivers came here. Hot laps. Hot laps give all the drivers a chance to stretch their car's legs, a few laps to make sure everything's working right. There's a good crowd tonight, gathered to get their racing fix after a long winter. And after one more spray of water on the track to settle the dust, the action begins. Heat races. Heat races determine the starting order for the feature races. The cars are divided up into smaller groups in each class and fight it out for position. Our first sign of trouble tonight is the 41 car piloted by Chris Deschamps pulls to the top of turn 2. Time for the Power Eye Midgets. These angry little bees are a downsized version of their big brothers, the sprint cars, but certainly not down on power or great racing. Close call with the 3 and the 44 cars as Wesley Smith jets through to take the win in heat number 2. The Outlaw Street Stocks are the bruisers of the bunch. These heavily modified street rides can give and take a beating all night long. One of the best races of the night comes from the 68 of Dean Willey and the 28 of Chris Kircher as Willey tries lap after lap to Kircher. Finally, the break the 68 needed as something breaks on the 28 off of turn 4. The modifieds are the F-16s of dirt racing. Sleek, agile, and powerful. They dance on the edge of control and traction. Moving up to the control tower, we get a different perspective as the E-Mods get their feature race underway.
Chris DeSong, and in row number 6, the number 68, Derek Brisbane. That is your starting lineup here for the E-Modified feature race of the night.
It's time to put up or shut up. The feature races are the only ones that really count. This is the race for the trophy. The race is monitored from up here. The position of each car is kept track of by an electronic system that is triggered by a sensor buried in the track at the start-finish line. One lap to go as the 3D car with Matt Dorsum takes it running away. We'll be right back. While the street stock feature has a smaller number of cars due to some not being able to start, they put on an amazing show, as always. Green flag racing allows the field to straighten out as Dean Willey pushes the 68M up front. The 8 car holds the top spot as the checkers comes out over the field. Time to bring on the B-Mods. With a solid field, the race gets off to a rocky start. A bad omen on the first night. Three-car pileup in turn one will end the night for a few. Teams now have the task of preparing their cars for the next week, and a driver takes a long walk back to the pits. Another car comes out with drivetrain problems, followed by a spin that brings out a caution again. Green flag, and we give you a front row seat to the action. Stretch wall. The 28 of Sean Burns is slowed, but remains in the race. The loose body panel comes off in turn one, and the yellow flag flies once more. Fitting in to a caution-filled race as the yellow comes out with the checkered flag to give the win to Dean Willey, a familiar name from the victory in the street stocks. Two races, two wins. Valley Sprints come from a long lineage of cars that rose to the most popular spectator sport of the 20s and 30s. And cars raced on tracks made of wood. Now it's just down and dirt. quick spin in the middle of 3 and 4. Pack manages to avoid a melee, and the greens back out quickly. Cars lean on their huge regular tires. The track takes on a shine as it gets polished lap after lap. The drivers must begin searching around for the best line with maximum grip. Cody Baker in the 38 has a half straightaway lead on the final circuit and will get his first win of the 2017 season. The final feature of the night goes to the Dirt Demon class. These four-cylinder cars may be little, but big speed can come in small packages. After a trouble-free race, Austin King brings the number 53 home with a win. At the end of the night, the winners gather together to bask in the glow of flash bulbs, hold their trophies, and celebrate in triumph. And as for the rest of the field, well, there's always
next weekend out here in Valley.
Feel the waves cut through me, hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight, hold tight, chemicals collide. Hold tight, hold tight, hold tight. Dripping lights paint the skies. I'll be